Is he a man? Is he a boy? Is he short? Is he tall? When you see him, you know it's him.
Captain, I can.
He's telling people they're fine to live their dreams, whether big or small. Never give up, that's what we say. The stars above are not too far.
Captain, I can.
You're working, don't know what to do at school and don't have a clue. Never give up,
that's what we say.
And today, it's a lovely day to be back.
It is a lovely day.
What day is today?
It's Monday, April 6th.
Oh yes, it's Monday, April 6th, 2020.
Yeah.
And we're glad to be back with you people out there.
It's great to be back.
And Mrs.Sonshine.
And we're coming to you from Icon Stationery Mart, 27 Slack Road, Kingston 5.
Oh yes, and what's our topic today?
Our topic today is fear versus faith.
It's fear versus faith.
And our scripture today is taken from 2 Timothy 1 verse 7. And what does that say? God has not given us
a spirit of fear,
but he has given us power, love, and a sound mind.
Let's see it again, Mrs.Sonshine.
For God has not given us a
spirit of fear,
but he has given us power,
love, and a sound mind. Wow, I find Mrs.Sonshine.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a great way to start.
Yes, it is.
It's a great way to start by telling people that God has not given them a spirit of fear.
Right.
Because in our world today, what is you're hearing all over the place. It's been talked about everywhere in every country in the world.
Yeah.
Coronavirus.
Yes, COVID-19.
COVID-19. That's what's been talked about by everybody.
And it's bringing a lot of fear.
It's bringing a lot of fear.
Everybody's being afraid.
Children are afraid.
Yeah.
The adults are afraid.
Yes.
The teachers are afraid. Everybody, the rich are afraid, the poor are afraid, the blacks are afraid, the whites are afraid, the fats are afraid, the slims are afraid. Everybody, the government is afraid, the people that live in the cellar is afraid. Everybody in every country in the world, there is fear.
Yes, and even the doctors and the nurses.
The doctors are afraid.
Are on our front line, they are afraid.
Yes, everybody, it's fear. Going all over the world. But we are here today as we have also been in different places of the world.
Yeah.
And we have been to schools talking to children before this, and we have always been encouraging them. And we would like to say this, that God has not given you a spirit of fear.
That's right.
So we're going to encourage you today. And our Bible says that God created the heavens and the earth. So God created the heavens and the earth and he saw everything and saw it was good.
Yes.
Now if God created everything, the Bible also said there's nothing new under the sun, right?
Nothing at all.
Nothing new. So everything was here when God created it. So God knew. And he knows all things.
That's right.
He knows everything. He knows before you were born.
Yeah.
Before you were formed in your mother's womb.
Yeah.
He said he knew you. He also says that he created everything. Therefore, it's amazing, Mrs.Sonshine. Our God created everything. And then, so he created the lions. He created the bears. He created everything.
Mm-hmm.
And he knew, because the prophets wrote about it in the Bible,
yeah,
that you had nuclear weapons.
Yeah.
They wrote about it in the Bible about the different pest pestilence and famines and earthquakes and violence, everything.
That's right.
So God let them root about all these things before, so that you can have the good book to see it. Mm-hmm. Now, interestingly, God saw all of those things and said to man, fear not. Because there's nothing to fear. Because God, my God, that's what God is saying, that He is with you.
That's right.
So He knew that there would be a virus. He knew that there would be sickness and pestilence all over the world. And He said, fear not.
Don't fear.
And He also said, the scriptures also said, Mrs.Sonshine, by the stripes of Jesus, we are healed.
Right, and that's awesome.
And that's awesome.
Yes.
Oh yes, I find Mrs. Sonshine. Because the Bible says where two or three are gathered in His name, there will be in the midst of us.
Right.
And if two or three touch anything, then we will see great things happen.
That's right.
Now, what it is that you are believing, what it is that you are afraid of, God said that there's nothing to fear. Absolutely nothing.
Nothing.
It doesn't make sense you run under your bed.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't make sense you hide. And I know you gotta follow the instructions by staying away from people. But Mrs. Sonshine, how are you so near to me?
Well,
social distance.
But yeah, social distance.
But guess what?
But you're armored up.
I'm armored up. Yeah. But you talk about social distance. They talk about washing your hands.
Yes.
They're talking about make sure that you don't put your hands and touch your face if it's dirty.
Mm-hmm.
It talks about wearing a mask.
Mm-hmm.
They talk about all these different things. Yes, you're going to follow that. But it's also important that you don't let fear take over your life.
That's right.
You don't let fear start to make you doing wrong things. Fear because you don't believe in the word of God.
Mm-hmm.
People are calling on the name of Jesus now, but they're speaking out of fear. They're praying out of fear. They're not praying in faith, believing, because there's a lot of people that believe that Jesus Christ came.
Yeah.
And they don't accept Him as Lord and Savior. They're going to be still on their way to hell. And there's a lot of Christians and people that call on the name of Jesus, but they don't believe that Jesus still provide, God still protect, God still keep. They don't believe that God still heal. They don't believe that, but they believe in Jesus and they accept Him as their Lord and Savior. Yes, they will go to heaven, but they will not experience His miracles and blessings on the earth. God said to us, we must occupy until He comes.
That's right.
So if He's not here, we have to occupy and take dominion on the earth until God comes.
That's right.
So God are looking for persons to stand in faith and start to speak some words.
That's right.
Start to speak not what you have, but what you want.
That's right, Captain.
Not what you have. You speak what you want. You speak because you want healing in your country. You want healing in your family. You want healing in the nation, the region, and the world. You got to speak that.
That's right.
You got to believe that. So you got to speak. And I'm going to speak, Mrs. Sonshine.
Yes.
Are you with me, Mrs. Sonshine?
I'm with you.
Of course. Right? So we're going to speak the word today.
Yes.
And we're going to just lift our hands in agreement and say, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
We declare. That coronavirus.
That coronavirus.
Dry up.
From the roots.
Out of this country, Jamaica. Out of every sick among us. Out of this land. In the name of Jesus. And then go all over the world. And dry up.
And dry up.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Christ of Nazareth.
We declare
healing
now in Jesus' name. And we thank you, God. That you will hear.
And
answer our prayers. And we thank you for victory. In the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, God. For touching our prime minister. The leaders of this land. Thank you for touching the doctors. The nurses. All these persons.
On the front line.
Fighting this virus.
We declare.
Healing upon them.
Creative ideas.
Witty inventions.
Show them what to do.
And when to do.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Give the Lord some praise. Woo! Oh yeah! Wow! It's been good. It's been good by just doing this short little thing. Speaking out there. And we said, fear not. There's nothing to fear. Because God is with you.
That's right.
And the scripture that we also said today is, God has what?
He has not given us
a spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. Just put your hands on your chest and say, God has not given me a spirit of fear. But he has given me power.
Love.
And a sound mind. In Jesus' name. Amen. Woo! We have a song to sing. Awesome. We have a song that we want to leave with, right, Mrs. Sonshine?
Yeah, and guess what? This song is from our friend
Jana and Lyra. Jenna came to children's praise break. Last year. We don't know what's gonna happen this year though, huh? Oh wow.
And Ron was here. Our husband Ron was here too.
Yes, her husband.
Ron, hi.
We had a great time in Jamaica. Yes, and we're gonna do this song for you from Jenna.
Yes.
Right, okay, let's get it moving. Never give up. See you again next time on Captain I Can.